Hey everybody, I'm Doug Meyer. Welcome to ATV Television, the television show for ATV enthusiasts and adventurers. Now, this week, we're heading on the enthusiast side because we're heading to the dunes with the Yamaha guys. Now, what's so cool about this is a chance for the Yamaha guys to invite a bunch of editors and also get not only the PR guys that we see all the time, but some of their R&D guys and behind the scenes guys to all just get out and have a good time. We just go there, camp for a few days, hang out, eat, go ride and do this stuff. Now, kind of sometimes you could look at it and go, we're kind of saddled with trying to get something out of it, like a show. But I want to tell you, this time, that wasn't on my mind. I was just out to have a good time to go riding in the dunes because I enjoy it so much. But now, you know, I don't know how many of you, especially if you're not, there's dunes across the U.S., of course, but there's no dunes. Well, there's some in Oregon that are pretty doggone good, some in Utah that are pretty good, Oklahoma, but Glamis, California is just immense. It's just the sand dune capital of the world. So if you're from someplace else, you're not really familiar with sand dunes, let me take a minute and tell you some of the things that you need. First of all, you really need a sport quad. And you've seen in the past shows that I've got several here that I use a lot, you know, that I've modified just for the dunes. My Kawasaki V-Force and my Suzuki LTZ 400. We're going to show you today that you can actually take box stock ATVs out there and have a great time. Now, some of the things you need, first of all, that you need no matter what dune system you go to, is a flag. And there's different kinds of flags here. You know, there's probably just the cheap old flag that you can buy, you know, from the place if you go there, that just bolts back to the back of your grab bar. And the reason, you'll see this on the video if you're not familiar with the dunes, but the height of this flag helps the other people see that you're approaching from the other side of the dune. Now, some of the other types of flags that you can put on, which you can fall over in the sand dunes, is this type right here. Now, you can see that this bolts on to your grab bar, and this pops in to here. Now, if you fall over or go to fall over and your leg hits it, it'll pop out. That's another pretty cool way to do it. I don't know if I like the looks of those because I like nice, simple, clean. These, you can bolt this onto your grab bar like this, and then if it breaks off right here, you actually just slide this down through here and then cut the bottom off that was all boogered up and put it on. Some of the cool stuff that buggies have a little bit better whips. This actually bolts onto the buggy part where there's an electrical connection. And on this end of the whip goes like a, 1157 bulb like would be in a tail light of an older Chevy truck. And so this will light up at night so that you've actually got lighting at night out on the dunes. Some of the other stuff that you really need, now, we have found that stock radials work tremendously well. But paddle tires, there's an assortment of paddle tires. You know, we use right now some of these ITP Sandstars, really good molded paddle tire, especially with the front that'll help steer in the soft sand like this with these little ridges. But there's also Scat Track makes tires. They buff them, leave it a little bit up there for the steering. You can get the smooth style for the front. Scat Track also takes these, buffs the whole thing off, and then vulcanizes on a paddle like that. You know what? I'm yammering on about what we need for the dunes, but let's watch some dune footage because it's cool. So, what's so special about the sand dunes? Well, being an avid automotive enthusiast and a writer for a diverse collection of automotive publications in my life has given me a rather broad base of experience and of friends. Now, one thing I found is that most of these friends seem to be of a much more narrow automotive purpose than I. Some of these friends are sports car people, and sports cars are what they do. Sports cars are what they think about, care about, or care to talk about, and that's what they live for. And the same holds true for friends who are racers, four-wheelers, hot rodders, and of course, ATVers. Their enthusiasm can be as narrow as their taste. Even just in the ATV world, there's a great diversity. Some folks trail ride and explore a new country. Some spend hours at a time seeing just how deep of mud they can get through. Some only use their ATVs for working or hunting. Some only for racing, and some live only for the sand dunes. And though I may not be able to commit myself to just a single form of vehicular or even ATV entertainment, I do admit to being partial to the sand dunes. That's a fact that I can never hide. Too many paddle tires stacked in the garage, I guess. Or maybe it's the fact that there's always a little bit of sand in the corner of my eyes. I'm not sure what always gives it away, but this passion regularly brings up the same question from my non-duning friends. What's so special about the sand dunes, anyway? So, let me share my answer with you. The answer that I've given in one form or another many times. The 10 reasons I like the sand dunes. And if you agree with them, then feel free to use any of them or all of them. And the next time you're asked a seemingly inane question, you can write these down and hand them to the next non-duner that asks you this question. Or, better yet, tape it to the water cooler at work. It'll save you a lot of time. You may also want to give a copy of it to your wife and your boss, the gas station attendant, and the grocery clerk, and your in-laws as well, past, present, and future. This may promote a better understanding of your behavior, especially around the holidays and those long full moon weekends. Come to think of it, though, it might bring all that misunderstanding in your life to a head. So you better use your discretion on handing this out. I'm not sure I want to be responsible for the outcome, all right? Okay, here goes. Number one, friends. The absolute best thing about the dunes is spending time with your friends. Friends that are of like mind and purpose. There's nothing as fulfilling or as rewarding to the damaged psyche as a weekend spent with a group of friends that can relate to such important topics as, would it be better to run smaller paddle tires? Or should I just stick with the stock radials? Should I run castor oil in my ATV's fuel? And why doesn't anyone make a cologne that smells like that? I'm sure you get the idea. While we talk plenty about religion and easily solve the world's problems, I've never talked about shopping experiences, and I never sit around and talk about what I'm going to do at work come Monday morning. Number two, freedom. The sand dunes are the last frontier for real riding freedom. On the dunes, there are no stoplights, no speed limits, and in fact, no roads, not even trails. It's this very freedom that seems to attract the great diversity of duners. Here the drag racers can race up the hills, and the sports car types can rat race through the dunes, and the four-wheel drive types can spend the weekend exploring the entire area. Number three, three-dimensionality. Now, there are places where you can ride up and down, as well as right and left, but the dunes are, well, different in this respect. Driving the dunes has been likened to surfing, except the wave never hits the beach. Or skiing, except with no forced ending at the bottom of the lift line. It's a roller coaster ride where you can constantly choose your route. It's like flying without ever leaving the ground. Number four, power. Sand takes power and you can use every bit of it. Unlike racetracks, our rutted and torn up trails, the dunes can be ridden as fast as your ATV and, of course, your ability can take you. Number five, options. In the dunes, you can play follow the leader for hours at a time. You can ride out to the hills and race each other up, or you can sit there and watch others. You can cruise easy or ride hard. And if you like jumping, well, there are so many shapes of dunes to jump, there's something for everyone. Number six, affordability. Yes, I know it's quite possible to spend incredibly large amounts of money on an ATV for the sand, but it's also quite possible to spend very little. Now, although there is a law that states you will always spend more than you plan, and you'll always spend more than you tell your wife, of course, it seems to have no effect on the fun factor that the ATV provides. As we proved here with the Yamaha folks, stock ATVs work incredibly well in the dunes without any modifications whatsoever. Number seven, camping. I have camped on dry lakes, alongside rivers, and under pine trees. None compare to a night at the dunes under the stars. Camping is really camping when you fall asleep, overcome by the smell of smoke, and dreaming of the past day's fun and the next day's adventures. Number eight, campfires. Ah, the smell of smoke. Good conversation and bad jokes. Solving the world's problems with the help of adult beverages, peanuts in the shell, and cigars. Campfires are as important to camping as rice is to beans, as milk is to cereal, as cheese is to pizza. Okay, I'm sure you get the picture. Number nine, camp food. Now, some people barbecue hamburgers, some steak. My own personal favorite is the easy and quick reheated pizza. Now, I've even lived an entire weekend on junk food and beer, and I must admit, Sunday morning brought on a panicked search for home-cooked food, for which, of course, I settled for just something hot. Number 10, clean. Now, this may sound like a silly reason, but as I get older, it has become more important. No other type of off-roading is as clean as the sand dunes. Sand is not dust, not mud, not dirt, and not a mess. It washes easily out of your hair, as well as the transmission and high-end joints. So, there you have it. I four-wheeled across the giant expanse of rocks at Moab and conquered the extreme trail called the Jackhammer. And I've ATV'd the Paiute Trail in the Mojave Desert. I've driven sports cars across the country. I've raced long-distance motorcycles and off-road cars. Yet nothing is quite as seductive as a weekend at the sand dunes. We'll be back with more